Hey there, it's another episode of Soundproofist, and today I want to talk about some of the questions I get from you about what kind of materials to use for different situations.
Sound absorption, dampening, and sound diffusion options. So we're going to take a quick look at some insulation, soundboard, homasote, and diffusers. And before we get started, I just want to be clear that the materials we'll cover in this video today aren't going to stop you from hearing your upstairs neighbor's feet pounding back and forth. Nevertheless, there are some other solutions I have to talk about with you today. So let's look at some of the materials you can use for sound absorption. Let's say you hear your neighbors through a shared wall, and it turns out that the wall isn't insulated. I've mentioned before that you can cut holes into your wall and blow cellulose insulation into it. You could also add another layer of drywall over the existing wall, like a layer of sound-dampened drywall called quiet rock. But let's say that you're remodeling and you want to open that wall up for some reason. Your local hardware store sells fiberglass bats. But what about Rockwool bats? What's the difference? Well, Rockwool is a little denser and it has a higher STC rating. That means it absorbs a little more sound than fiberglass. I've got some samples here. The pink and yellow pieces are fiberglass, and the light brown one is Rockwool Safe and Sound, which is Rockwool. You can see that the Rockwool is a little bit denser. It doesn't compress flat like the fiberglass. According to some data, the STC rating of fiberglass bats is about 38. And the STC rating of Rockwool is somewhere between 45 to 50. So to me, it's worth it to use Rockwool. And Rockwool is made in different grades too, for ceilings and for thermal comfort, not just for walls. You might have seen a YouTube video where someone demonstrates that Rockwool is fireproof and doesn't burn. Supposedly, a home that's insulated with Rockwool is not going to burn down as quickly as one with hollow walls or a different kind of insulation. And I've also read that fiberglass, even though it's fire resistant, can melt inside the walls. So I'm going to do a quick burn test with a match. Let's see what happens. And here you can see that the fiberglass gets charred and the fluffiness kind of shrinks and hardens under the flame and the fibers melt together. Now when I put the match under the Rockwool, it also gets charred, but it retains its shape and it doesn't seem to be shrinking or compressing like the fiberglass does. And here are the results for the Rockwool and the fiberglass. You can also use Rockwool or fiberglass to build your own sound panels and hang them on a wall or ceiling to absorb some room noise. These are helpful in music studios, in restaurants, in an office, or any place with hard, flat surfaces that creates a lot of noise reflection and reverberation. Makes it hard for you to hear the person you're talking to. You can also dampen noise with something called Soundboard. It's pretty inexpensive. Here you can see it's about $17 per sheet. It's lightweight and somewhat porous, and it really helps to mute the sound a lot. It's made from recycled fiberboard, and I asked the people in my local hardware store if this soundboard is fire rated, and they said no. I'm not sure if that's completely accurate. Some of these products are fire rated for 1 hour when they're inside a wall that's already covered with gypsum board, like this product called SoundStop. It's supposed to have an STC rating of 42 when it's installed inside a wall assembly. The soundboard in this store says it has an STC rating of 22, though that could be on its own and not in tandem with other materials. Here's an example of how it's used. When one of my downstairs neighbors soundproofed their ceiling, the installers put soundboard in between each floor joist against the bottom of the subfloor upstairs. Notice how it's angled a little bit to deflect the sound even more. This helped to eliminate all conversation noise between the upstairs and downstairs apartments. Homasote is dense and firm, and it's made of recycled cellulose fibers that were treated with fire retardant. Imagine if you took cellulose insulation and then compressed it really hard into a half-inch thick board that you can cut with a saw. It's an old-school soundproofing material. I've used it myself inside a wall cavity between each wall stud before I put the insulation in. Basically, I cut the Homasote so that it fit between each stud, and I used green glue to adhere it to the back of the drywall on the other side. This added more mass on the inside of the wall. But of course, the drywall on the other side wasn't decoupled from the wall studs, so some vibration and low frequency can still get transmitted through. The STC of Homasote, when it's inside a wall assembly, is about 53, which is pretty good. And that is, I assume, when it's combined with other soundproofing materials. I also use Homasote on top of my kitchen cabinets. That's because I have some stereo speakers on the cabinets and I don't want the sound to pass into the wall and into my neighbor's apartment. You can see that it has a textured surface on it, which you could paint if you like. I think you can also use Homasote on top of a subfloor and underneath a laminate floor, though you should also add a foam underlayment to soften the footfalls. These are samples of wood slat diffusers. You've probably seen them on some walls or ceilings. They reduce echo, plus they look really nice. The idea is to diffuse and absorb noise. The wood slats with the soft backing have better acoustics than a flat solid wall because solid surfaces bounce noise. And behind the slats, there's this thick layer of recycled felt. So the sound passes between the slats into the felt where it gets absorbed. The materials are treated with fire retardant. I think they look great, and they could be used on top of a gypsum or concrete wall, or maybe on a ceiling, like in a part of a restaurant or an office or a corridor. They're not cheap, though. For example, on Amazon, you can buy them in a pack of two panels for about $120. Each one is 2 feet by 4 feet. The description says that two panels will cover about 15 square feet, so that's only a small amount of coverage. If you had a 10 by 12 wall, you'd have to buy about 8 packages to cover it with this paneling. And that could cost about $960. You could also get creative and build your own diffuser out of something like pegboard and put a closed cell foam backing on it. I think it might be more effective if you separated the pegboard from the foam backing. Maybe create a 1/4 inch gap with furring strips or dense foam strips to create a small airspace between the pegboard and the backing. I've read in some musician forums that pegboard might not be the most effective diffuser, but I'm not sure how it was implemented. I also saw a ceiling made of pegboard as a diffuser in a hotel hallway, and it minimized some of that corridor noise along with wall-to-wall carpeting. So pegboard at a place like Lowe's in the USA costs about $22 per 4x8 panel. That doesn't include the cost of the foam or EVA backing or any furring strips, but the cost of just a pegboard for that same hypothetical 10 by 12 foot wall would be a little under $100. And remember, a solution like this will absorb some noise inside the room or corridor, but it doesn't stop outside noise from coming in. These are just a few examples of how to get creative ideas to solve noise problems. Thanks for watching, and to learn more about noise and acoustics, visit soundproofist.com.